All right. So Leemon, I hear that there's a bit of interesting information that you might want to share with us. I guess we've heard about the Mirrornet that's going to be associated with the Hedera Hashgraph platform. I guess what exactly is the Mirrornet and how does this kind of fit into the platform overall?
Ah, yes. This is cool. So you have the mainnet,
Yep.
and you're not going to have lots of computers in a single shard. That would just, there's no point in doing that. We'll eventually have lots of shards, but that's the mainnet, and that's where your HBARs live, and that's where your smart contracts run. And then we have testnets that we're using for testing, and the hackathon today is going on testnets.
Yep.
Then we have the Mirrornet.
Okay.
The Mirrornet can grow to millions or billions. Sort of as a single shard, it could be millions or billions. It doesn't hurt anything. And it is getting a complete copy of everything that happens in the regular net, in the main net. So all the transactions flowing through the main net also flow to the mirror net, and all those nodes get them. And each main net node has to run the smart contracts and save the files.
Right.
Same thing on the mirror nets. A mirror net node has to run the smart contracts and save the files. It's doing everything that the regular nodes do,
Right.
but merely listening, not talking.
Right.
And it's pull, not push. I mean, it's push from the mainnet, not pull
Right.
from the mirror nodes. So they can't disrupt the mainnet. There's nothing they can do to corrupt it or disrupt it. They don't have to have public keys with which they sign things. They just can get signed up as being one of the people that gets things pushed to them, and then they gossip to each other, and it's tit for tat, and
Yep.
we have all that stuff.
Right. A mirror of
It's a mirror
yeah.
of the net.
Exactly.
You got it. That's it. And so then the idea is that if I were going to go to the regular net, I could say, what's my balance? Or did my transaction I just did go through?
Right.
You could go to a mirror net node and get the same information.
Right.
The mainnet node could give me a state proof to prove it's not lying.
Right.
So can the mirror net node.
Oh,
The
interesting.
state proof has all the digital signatures from the mainnet.
Right, because it's just pulling that information.
That's it. And the mirror net node doesn't even sign anything.
Okay.
It's just passing it along. It just gives me the pieces of information I need.
So I guess what would be the benefits of having that kind of replica of the mainnet versus just
Yeah.
going straight to the mainnet?
So they can do more than what I just said.
Okay.
Every transaction passes through them just like a regular mainnet node, and every mainnet node throws it away after a few seconds because you don't need it anymore.
Right.
A mirrornet node could put them all in a database and keep them forever.
Got it.
A mirrornet node could do data analysis on the hash graph going back for years.
Got it.
It could sell you what was your balance a year ago and mathematically prove to you that it's true, that they're not lying. All those things. They could do a pub/sub system. You could say, whenever certain things happen, send me an email. The mirrornets could do that. They could have a subscription service for that or micropayments for that. They could do all kinds of things with this information that the mainnet's not going to bother with.
Got it.
And they can get it for free. Anybody will be able to do it. You don't have to actually pay for it, except you have to pay the bandwidth to, run basically a regular node.
Well, I also see there are probably benefits of someone actually using the MirrorNet to also build some sort of dApp or some other application that basically does data analytics or analysis of the platform.
Yes, all kinds of data analytics and analysis of the platform. There's a lot you can do. The hash graph is a graph. There's all sorts of deep graph analysis you could do going back on the history. You know other things too. Maybe you just want to run a node because you want to be able to see everything and not pay for the information. You just want it all for free.
Sure.
Or maybe your company wants to run a node of the MirrorNet and then give everybody in the company access to the information for free.
Okay.
So I said you could sell the information, but you can also give it away for free. You
Right.
can do whatever you want to do with it.
Right. And then I guess would you need to have like the actual like HBAR to power the MirrorNet or?
Nope. Don't need anything to do that.
Right.
And so on the regular network, I could submit a transaction and then I could pay to find out for sure that it really happened, or I could go to my mirror node that I'm running and get it for free.
There you go.
And there you go.
So I can imagine that there's going to be a lot of benefits of running that. And I guess, is there any other kind of like platforms out there that has something similar, or is there anything that we can maybe compare that to?
Yeah, I mean, there's block explorers, blockchain explorers,
Okay.
that use things sort of like that, but it's not exactly the same.
Okay.
Because we're different than our mirrornet's different
Right.
than things that you'd know. It is actually sort of different from other things that I've heard of out there. But that's just because we're sort of different in some ways.
Exactly.
So that's good.
Well, Leemon, I really appreciate learning more about the MirrorNet and
Sure.
really appreciate having your time, and we look forward to hearing more about the platform overall. So,
Great. Well, thank you.
all right.